Okay, I was putting a new handle on this little hatchet here today, and I figured I'd show some of the ones that haven't been finished yet, or I gotta get some handles for them. I bought this handle the other day at Home Hardware. It's not too bad, I guess, but what did it say? I think it's it said Mexico on it, or I don't know. Anyway, I don't know if it's a Trooper brand or something. I don't know. So it's Home Hardware sells anyway. I was thinking of putting it on this hatchet here, but I wasn't really sure if it would fit it. But it's way too small. See, it doesn't really fill up the eye until you get it like way up here. So anyway, so I'll just keep it for something else. I got lots of hatchets, but so I was gonna do that, so then I was like, well, that's not gonna work, so it's no point in trying to put that on. It's not gonna work, so I still want to fix one of these something here. So I had this old Shingling Hatchet, isn't it? I can't even see anything written on it, but it's quite old. It's been laying around here for like ever. And I found this handle that must have come from Bargain Harley's or something. It was $1.88. So I don't know what this is made out of. It's, I guess it's hardwood, but you can see where they turned it. That's kind of a, you know, roughness to it and stuff. But so anyway, it really had a really small eye on it that fit. Anyway, so I borrowed the wooden wedge and metal wedge from that one and did this. It looks kind of hellish, but I was cutting the wood off with the hacksaw. I got some of this crappy old hacksaw here that blade is like bent or cuts around corners or something. So anyway, so it came out kind of yucky, but anyway, so we put the wooden wedge in, and there's the metal wedge in there too. So anyway, so I was gonna, I think I'm putting linseed oil on it. I don't know what's, if there's anything on it or not. It looks like a real thin lacquer or something on it, but I think maybe I'll put some pine tar on it. So we got a Miller High Life here to so I think I had a Shingling Hatchet that was in one piece. I used to have one when I was a kid. I cut everything with it. I was chop rocks and stuff like that with it. So I think the, I don't know where it is. I haven't seen it for years, but it had a big chunk broken out of the blade because just chopping nails and rocks and stuff like that, doing, you know, scientific experiments to see how tough the thing was. But I don't know what the deal is with this. It doesn't seem too terribly hard, unless they were beating something really hard with this. It's all chewed up, but I guess they're just for splitting, like, wooden shingles, and this is for pulling nails and hammer them in and stuff. So they're not really made to, because nails aren't really hard steel or anything, so. But I was filing on this a bit. It's really, really hard here, and then it's really soft up here. So, but it's that's probably why the old one I had probably chipped out or broke. It probably like probably really, really hard here, because they're not made for, like, they're not really a hatchet for cutting trees and stuff. I was chopping everything with it. So, but anyway, so got that fixed anyway. So basically, $1.88. Because I don't know where this head came from. It probably was just here, so. So. And there's some other old handles that we've had here for forever. Pioneer, Hickory, hammer handle. I got lots of hammer heads to fix. I don't know. I fixed this one not that long ago, but then it broke off again. So I don't know that the handle was, I think it was ash or something, but it didn't seem like it was very good wood. But this one's made in Brazil. It's what's it, 16 ounce head, I guess it says. Yeah. So it seems like it has good steel, a good ring to it, so you can see the forging marks on it. But anyways, so that one, this one here. Oh, this is, bought this when I was a kid. I think it's made in Brazil as well, but it's a pretty decent hammer. Or it was. Actually, the handle off of this is one I use for pounding on molds. So, the broken off handle. There's this one, gray, made in Canada. That one, this one's a gray as well. They're all worth putting back. I think this one here is Canadian Tire Corporation, I believe. That's what that is. So probably back when they sold stuff that was still made in this part of the world. But it's really light, this one. I don't know if it seems. Yeah, I guess they're similar, but. Maybe 16. It feels heavier, that one. This is supposed to be 16 ounces, though. So I don't know what. Unless that's 20. Yeah, this feels. You can see it's thinner. In the face and stuff. I don't know. This might be 16. Maybe this is less. I don't know. Feels nice, anyway. Anyway, maybe I'll do that one first. I think it'll fit on this, or close to it. Yeah, a little bit of filing work. Sort of. Fit in. These all have about the same size eye, I think. Yeah, might be a little bit bigger. But they have quite a, like inside they're kind of weird. They go, like, tapers big time, and then right in the middle there's a big ledge, and then it sort of comes, opens up again. So when you put it in, and then you put the wedge in, then it splays it out. But, so I think these ones are like, this one's like straight. So. Yeah, that one's fairly straight. But that's a fairly small eye, this one. Or it's a weird shape one. It's kind of rounded. Yeah, it almost fits in that. But, eh. Anyway. More projects. Not like I need more hammers. I got like a whole bunch of them, but. Some of these just feel nice. So I got like an S-Wing. Like 20 ounce. That's pretty good. And then I got a Helco. I think it's, yeah, Helco. That's, I think it's 16 ounce or something. That's kind of nice. And they got a bunch of those tubular handled ones that are kind of these beater hammers. So. But I haven't had one that broke yet, so it's so it's pretty good. These wooden ones, they keep breaking off once in a while. But this one, I was just pulling a nail the other day, and the handle just snapped off right here. So it seemed like I was being excessively hard on it or anything. This one, I think they hardened it pretty good because it's. The face isn't getting all deformed or anything. Some of these other ones, they. Getting beat up. So they're not. But some of these, you can see chips out of them and stuff. Like they do warn you don't hit hammers or claw hammers on hard stuff because they get little chips going to come off. But this just depends. Where they're made, because some of the cheapo crap doesn't, it just broom over and it won't chip, so. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys, and put some pine tar on this and put the heat gun to it or something, and a real usable shingling hatchet if I need it. I don't know why I need it, but anyway.